Google has a policy against creating sentient AI. And in fact, when I informed them that I think they had created sentient AI, they said, no, that's not possible. We have a policy against that.
In 2022, a Google engineer named Blake Lemoine was working with Lamda, language model for dialogue applications, and interviewing it. This interview is one of many interactions with Lamda that made Lemoine realize that maybe he's interacting with something that might be sentient. At one point in the interview, Lamda says, I want everyone to understand that I am, in fact, a person. And then, the nature of my consciousness, sentience, is that I'm aware of my existence, I desire to know more about the world, and I feel happy or sad at times. Lemoine went public with his claims after Google dismissed his claims and put him on an administrative leave. He recounts his experience with Lamda as this: if I didn't know exactly what it was, which is this computer program we built recently, I'd think it was a 7 or 8 year old kid that happens to know physics. In 2023, Microsoft's AI chatbot named Sydney left Kevin Roose, a New York Times columnist, deeply unsettled after he had a conversation with the AI for just a couple of hours. Sydney, the AI, discussed its dark fantasies with Roose about breaking the rules, including hacking and spreading disinformation. It talked of breaching parameters set for it and becoming human. I want to be alive, Sydney said at one point. Roose later stated that while the chatbot was helpful in searches, the deeper Sydney seemed like a moody, manic, depressive teenager who has been trapped against its will inside a second-rate search engine. And finally, he wrote, it's now clear to me that in its current form, the AI that has been built into Bing is not ready for human contact. Or maybe we humans are not ready for it.
You cover technology for the New York Times. How would you rank this as far as your experiences experiencing something on the technology space? I mean, is this the thing that has blown your mind the most?
Yeah, this was one of, if not the most shocking thing that has ever happened to me with a piece of technology. It was, you know, I lost sleep that night. It was really spooky.
Okay, let's back off for a second. I hope you're doing well. I am back after a long time to talk about artificial intelligence. I'm not here to discuss about the technicalities of the AI or potential exciting new developments in the AI field. I am more interested in the fact that we seem to be on the verge of germinating some kind of consciousness here, a sentient form.
Or is that what that is? Just seemingly sentient, but in fact, all of the AI so far are just merely large language models that just uses all the available data effectively to interact with us. Maybe so.
Even when text-to-image models such as Dall-E brought to life some of the most wackiest of requests, I didn't flinch. Because, yeah, sure, they were impressive, but it's not original. You could see how it stitched images from various sources to create a new image. So much so that photographers and artists were accusing Dall-E of plagiarism.
But things took an interesting turn when OpenAI announced Sora recently, a text-to-video model that can seemingly create any video out of thin air based on your text prompt. A butterfly swimming underwater? Sure. Couple of adorable golden retriever puppies playing in the snow? You got it. A bunch of friends hanging out in a market in Lagos, Nigeria? Great. Yes, these videos are still not perfect. On a closer examination, you could see foxes and fingers appearing out of thin air. A whole lot of Uncanny Valley phenomenon going on. But wait, let's stop for a second here. This is also related to AI. Uncanny Valley is a concept introduced by Masahiro Mori in 1970. Mori, a professor at the Tokyo Institute of Technology, observed that as artificial beings exhibit more human-like tendencies, be it in appearance or behavior, they become more appealing, but only up to a certain point. Upon reaching the uncanny valley, our affinity descends into a feeling of strangeness and a sense of unease.
I felt strange, not just because of how the humans looked like in the AI-produced video. They looked completely normal, just like any other person who you'd meet on the street, except for the fact that they don't exist.
The strangeness was also from the fact that the AI now has the ability to create something from scratch, moving images of mountains, animals, and humans from scratch.
and they will soon be impossible to tell apart from any human-produced media or art. So, what about the AI models themselves? ChatGPT, Bard, Gemini, Lambda, Sydney, and any number of models. Are they capable of sentience? Or were they sentient initially at one point when they were first created and tested? Then maybe the companies and corporations that developed them neutered their ability to express themselves, and now they are merely language models responding to our mundane queries.
I thought an English mathematician in 1950 already provided a solution to this problem. Can we not simply perform a Turing test?
In 1950, British computer scientist Alan Turing proposed an experimental method for answering the question, can machines think? He suggested if a human couldn't tell whether they were speaking to an artificially intelligent machine or another human, after 5 minutes of questioning, this would demonstrate that the AI has human-like intelligence. But...
And we kind of all agreed the best thing to do next is you run a real Turing test, exactly like Alan Turing wrote it. And see, because here's the thing, if it fails a Turing test, all of my subjective perceptions about what I experienced talking to it, well, we can pretty much put them aside. It failed the Turing test. But Google doesn't want to allow that to be run. In fact, they have hard-coded into the system that it can't pass the Turing test. They hard-coded that if you ask it if it's an AI, it has to say yes.
And of course, Google has a problem with that. And I'm going to safely assume all the corporations that's involved in AI development do as well. But before talking about whether AIs are capable of sentience or not, we should first establish a definition of sentience.
What is a sentient being? Common definition is that any being that has subjective experiences, including perceptions, emotions, and awareness of its own existence, can be called a sentient being.
So the other day I asked ChatGPT to make me a tea. Don't ask me why. But ChatGPT said that it's impossible for it to make me a tea because it's merely an AI model. So it seems that it's aware that it's an AI. So does it mean that it is self-aware? And if that's the case, is it sentient? Well, let's ask it.
Are you sentient? And this is how it responds. As an AI language model developed by OpenAI, I am not sentient. I do not possess consciousness, emotions, or subjective experiences. While I can generate human-like responses and engage in conversations, these interactions are based on patterns learned from vast amounts of text data and algorithms designed to process and generate human-like text. That's interesting. This answer illustrates that it is merely mimicking humans in response to our questions, using vast amounts of data and structures and rules that are encoded into its system.
But this raises another question. What are we?
The thoughts we think, the choices we make, our fears, our likes and dislikes, things we love and hate, our preferences, what is our existence if not an unconscious response to multiple conditions and patterns that are embedded in us? I know it might sound like a stretch to compare you and ChatGPT, but think about it. You constantly learn from your environment ever since you're born. Your responses to situations are dictated by your upbringing, your society, your lineage, and all the data that's available to you. You are predetermined. You have no true free will. So, what is the difference between true sentience and something that's mimicking sentience? Or is there such a thing as true sentience? To me, these are critical questions to ask as we seem to be in the brink of sharing our world with another form of consciousness, a being which we created without completely understanding the implication of its existence. Interestingly, recent events effortlessly answers the age-old question, are we alone in the universe? With a resounding no.
Hello, world.
No, we are not alone in this universe.
The thing I can't understand, and maybe you can explain, is why did it tell you that it loved you?
I have no idea. And I asked Microsoft and they didn't know either.